consider the very fundamentals of liberty, which to me would be teaching my horse that I'm the herd. Wherever the herd goes, it's their job to stay with the herd. Does that make sense? Seems like a good starting point. I also believe this is a really important starting point, because at some point your horse is going to leave while you're trying to do something at liberty. And if my starting point was creating a way to bring the horse back to me, where they understood it's their responsibility to come back to me, I don't have to rely on my fences so much. Does that make sense, everybody? So that's what we're going to start with. Now, I brought I think she's a five-year-old. Her name's Say. She's been in training a couple weeks now. And I thought, I like showing how to start teaching it versus bringing my horse in here who already does it. She's not going to make a mistake, and then it wouldn't be clear if your horse makes a mistake what to do. The other thing is, this is a new environment for her, and she's very distracted. You guys can see that. You can see if I kind of walk over here. She's not really paying a lot of attention to me, is she? Even though I'm online. So we're going to take the halter off, and I'm going to be building on one of the concepts that I shared with you guys yesterday, location and direction. Okay, location and direction. And see if we can get her to understand that it's her responsibility to stay with the herd. So I'm going to walk off there. And you can see I'm over here and she's over there. So what I'm going to do is try to make the space around me the relief. So she chose to stay there, disconnected, not connected with me. I'm going to now go and own that spot. That is the first natural part to communicating to a horse, you're the alpha. So the herd leader doesn't follow the other horses. They set where the herd is going to go. Does that make sense, everybody? So we need to start off with being the herd leader. So not trying to bribe her to come into me. Does that make sense? Like, you might get a horse to follow you around for cookies, but they're kind of there under a false pretense. Does that make sense? It's not going to be as strong as that connection you're going to build from being the actual herd leader. Okay? So we're going to start with that point of view. Now, there's two principles that I do my best to follow with anything I do with a horse, period. Principle number one, I'm going to work with the horse where they're at. Okay? Now, I could try to make her do a bunch of things, but where is she really at right now? She's not with me, is she? She's smelling the ground, she's checking things out, okay? Now, part principle number two that I like to follow is do less first. You cannot go wrong with a horse by doing less first, okay? Now, by doing less first, what I mean by that is me just walking away from her and saying, I'm asking you to be with me, you're not with me, you're over there, okay? Now, she's not with me and she's not looking at me. Ideally, I would have her in a direction where she was faced completely away from me. I would like to sign her up to her mistake, okay? So the ideal position is right here. You guys see that? She's faced away from me. Now I'm gonna go own the space where those hind feet are. You can see I got the patty. So I just made where she's at her most committed to her mistake of looking away, that's where pressure came on. Well, looky there. I found a friend. Then I just stood here, didn't I? I didn't look at her. I didn't follow her. My belly button is pointed at you guys. So also you got to understand the most pressure that you have lives in here and in here, your eyeballs and your belly button. That is the most pressure you could put on. Okay, so I turned that away from her. Now, she chose to come at this angle. She's confident with people there. That's a good deal. Now, if that was a hard thing for them to find, which it wasn't for her, she came right back to me, right? So I'm going to now walk away. If that was a hard answer for her to arrive at, I might hang out here for a minute, let her get relief there, okay? But now I'm going to walk away again. She's got some decisions to make. The herd just left. She chose to hang out there. Own that space again. Now, you guys see I went dead center to my line and put pressure where she was at? Good choice. So what I'm getting at is I want you to go on the line to the spot. The spot is where their hind feet are at, and it's their choice to get out of the way or not. Now, she kind of disconnected from me, looked over there. Herd's gonna leave again. got a choice to make. Oh, she made a good choice, didn't she? Because no pressure has been on her when she's with me. Pressure came on when she was away from me. It was very clear to her where the relief is. I guess if I was going to add a principle number three, it would be sign them up. And what I mean by sign them up is let your horse commit to their mistake. This is especially true with cow working, especially true with Liberty. If she just started, like over there, imagine it, she looked over there, didn't she? And I was here, she kind of disconnected, and then I walked away. That was signing her up. You're with me or you're not. I didn't know. She chose to connect. What if I had tanned her hide for looking away from me right next to me? I would have just made the space around me the bad deal. That would have been really uncomfortable. Now she's not going to want to be with me. What I'm getting at is not any of you guys, but maybe you have a friend that their horse started to leave and they saw the mistake happening and they went for broke to tan that horse's hide for making a mistake. And then that horse learned to associate that pressure with you. Not you guys, but a friend. The people that aren't here. You guys know what I'm talking about? And now it's a hard deal to get them to want to be with you. Let them leave. Go, I see you leaving. There you go. Okay, you made it to the fence. You have all the way left. Now I'm going to go own that space. And all the credit for that pressure gets associated with the horse thinking out by the fence. Does that make sense? What this does, where this goes, is to what Jake was doing, where you end up in the middle of the round pen, teaching the horse the relief is in here. So since she caught on to that pretty quickly, I might have her, oh, she left again. Watch, let that happen. Oh, I see you looking out over there. Now here's an interesting, oh, set it up and wait. So you're finding the relief there? She came in, but she was a little bit defensive still, a little bit bracy. And then she lowered her head. She's licking and chewing, getting relief here. Some horses, it's easier if you move for them to stay hooked on with you. That feels better to them to move their feet. Some horses, they feel better if you just stand still and do nothing. Pick whatever one is going to work for your horse to help them get more comfortable with you. Do that. Okay? So some of you, I'm going to say move more. Some of you, I'm going to say hey, don't move. I also am going to encourage you, don't pet your horse. Don't treat your horse. Don't scratch your horse at this time. I do all those things to my horse all the time. But I don't do it for the next 3 days while I'm teaching them find your herd. The reason is, I don't want there to be any other extra reason that they're with me other than I'm the herd, I'm where their comfort is, I'm where the relief is, I'm the alpha, because I just owned your space. Does that make sense, everybody? Yep. Then, once we graduate past that spot, I want all 10% that I can get out of my liberty from that move. All 10 of it, not 5 of it. So then I can start adding in some of those other things. You guys see where I'm going with that? But I feel like if you start to do any of those little things, especially if you've owned your horse for a while, those become little cues. The other day I worked with a dog trainer and he said, well, let's see where your dog's at. And he said, so you see your dog running around chasing Gus? I'm like, yeah, I see her. He goes, lay her down. I'm like, okay. Paige, he goes, don't look at her. Don't look at her, don't step towards her. Just say the cue, lay down. I went. He goes, don't lean. Don't lean. Just say down. I said, down. Paige had no idea. Because I'm used to doing this and connecting with her down. And I do a lot of cues that I didn't even know I was doing. So what he's getting at is it's a much stronger cue if you do less first. You guys picking up what I'm putting down here? Uh-huh. Okay, now stage two of this. Now I want to start in here. Like Jake said, we got to start moving our feet less. Can I be here? So now my next goal is to put that horse on a circle. And while they're circling, so it's basically find your herd in motion. We got find your herd at a standstill. Can we play find your herd at walk, trot, canter? Okay? And the deal is, there's hot lava around the outside of this round pen. If that horse is here, they are on hot lava. I'm going to go make this hot lava. If they're on the inside, that shows me that horse isn't leaning on the fence. They're getting relief. Does that make sense? So I'm gonna let them fully commit to being on the hot lava, leaning on the fence, and then I'm gonna run back to the center of the pen and wait for them to come find me in there. Make sense, everybody? So being out here is easy for them to find you. She was already out here on her own, right? Can your horse find you in the center of the pen? Let's find out. Dun, dun, dun. Now, if you strike off to go put pressure on your spot, and that horse turns and looks at you, stop. Cease and desist. You do not want to put pressure on a connecting thought. I made that mistake a bunch. I thought, well, they're not here with me. I'm going to get them. And they'd look at me and I'd keep going. I'm coming. Still putting pressure on. And then I would teach them, when you look at me, there's going to be pressure sometimes. I don't want to teach that. I'm going to wait for my moments. That make sense, everybody? So now once I have her in the center of the pen here, now I'm going to ask for that circle. So I'm going to back up here. And now I'm going to give her the best chance I can give her. Could you find this circle here? See, I'm backing up. This is easy. This is kindergarten here, okay? I like it. I like what we got going here. It's a pretty good deal right there, guys.
Yeah.
We'll take that. Mm-hmm. We'll see if we're trotting now.
Wow. Girls are smart.
We'll bring her in. Good deal. Give her a hand, guys. That was pretty good, huh?
Good job, Kay. Good job, girl.
Look at her, too. What? Back up again. Push here. Out of way. Now, what this tells me is we've had some good preparation work here, haven't we? She's not afraid of pressure, but we built a stronger connection, didn't we? So you can see we had a lot of good stuff set up ready for this. But right off the bat, she wasn't with me. And I could have cued her. I could have been like, disengaged. I could have begged her to come with me. Or I could go, no, I'm going to do less first. And I'm going to ask you to commit. And that's what the first starting point of liberty is. Now, here's the deal. Do you think if I kept challenging her here and I started doing side passing, changing directions, cantering, spinning, do you think she might leave at some point? Probably. So if she leaves, I have a default pattern to go to, don't I? If she leaves and I go and spank the spot, she knows, get your butt back to Ryan. I love that. That means I don't have to spend a bunch of time with a horse running around the pen, pending they're not real emotional in all, some other situations. But for the most part, I'm going to greatly reduce the amount of time I'm in a pen with a horse and they're leaving. And then once you have it in here, see if you can play the game in there. See if you can play the game in their paddock. Walk into your pasture and go, the leader has arrived. Does my horse connect? You're not connecting with me? I'm going to go get your butt. Teach them to come catch you. And then once you have this connection where that horse is looking for you already, and then you give them the cue, you bring them in, now that horse can come running. You guys see what I'm saying? But if that horse is your baseline, is they're thinking outside the round pen, and I just tried to train her the cue to come running to me, I'm at a difficult disadvantage right away. You guys hear them coming with us? So I'm trying to give you the very baseline layer of liberty. Can you start with your horse thinking you are the herd, and it's their job to stay connected with the herd?